His time.
Thanks, Koshy. Well, there's a growing push from within the government to open our borders sooner than mid-2022, as projected in last week's budget. Liberal MPs Dave Sharma, Tim Wilson and Jason Falinski would also like vaccinated Aussies given a greater opportunity to travel. It comes as the PM says welcoming international students back to Australia is the next step in our recovery, but the repatriation of citizens who have contracted the virus in India is not being considered. For more, we're joined by Liberal MP Jason Falinski. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
A news poll published in The Australian this morning found 73% of Australians think borders should stay closed until mid-2022. Do you think you're out of touch?
Look, it's a totally understandable reaction to most Australians when you have a couple of premiers telling people that they should be scared. Of course, people's natural reaction is to pull their heads in and create sort of a fortress mentality. But it doesn't need to be that way. We spend a lot of money keeping families safe. We don't want to keep them apart.
So we've had, 18 months of this. We've seen a lot of countries in a lot of trouble. We've just heard the former Deputy Chief Medical Officer say, we should need about 70, 80, 90% of people vaccinated before we maybe consider something like this. Do you think we're going to get there?
Well, look, I think what Nick is saying, and I think what a lot of medical experts are saying, is that if once you're vaccinated, there should be sort of a two-way approach. So people who haven't been vaccinated would need to come, leave the country after application, come back, quarantine in a hotel system before they go back into go home. However, people who have been quarantined, and the Prime Minister's been talking about this in the last couple of days, could have a different system where they don't need to apply, they can quarantine at home. And I think that starts to free up people being able to come and go to Australia. And the benefits of that are that we are living in one of the most ethnically diverse countries in the world. There isn't someone who doesn't have a friend, family or someone they care about living overseas, and we're keeping them apart.
But do you trust people to quarantine at home? Because most people have a normal house, they don't have a west wing where they can really stay, you know.
There's only one person that has a west wing, but
exactly.
Yes.
Exactly. So how do you stay separated from your family for 2 weeks? I've done hotel quarantine. It's a long time.
It's a long time. And look, I mean, if the last 18 months show us anything, it is that Australians can be trusted. I mean, I come from the Northern Beaches. We're the part of Australia that saved Christmas, and we did that by 70,000, 80,000
people. You didn't save mine. I couldn't go to WA because the borders were locked. So you actually destroyed quite a few.
And that goes to it, right, that we have a couple of premiers who are, you know, playing to people's prejudices about this rather than explaining to people what the facts are. So we've had medical experts from Brett Sutton and Nick Coatsworth coming out today saying there are opportunities for us to open up and to allow people to reunite with family members both here and around the world. And instead of playing to people's worst fears, we should be playing to people's best hopes.
Okay. Thanks very much for your time.
Thanks, Dan.
Here's Koshy.
Now, at least 42 Palestinians are being killed by Israeli airstrikes.